Good morning, sir.
Yes, good morning, everyone.
Good morning, sir.
Yes, good morning, Priyanshi. So, last time we have worked with the SQL and we will continue with that. One more announcement I have made on that day, please select your subject topic in this week only. So first today the first we will have a small quiz on smartphone. So you can note down the web link www.kahoo.in.it, and the game number is 740-6668. So this is a small quiz on smartphones. I hope that you will enjoy the session and learn a bit more about the smartphones. So, waiting for the players. The web link is this one, kahoo.it, and the game number is this. So before that, first let's have the attendance from 12A. Any student from 12A, 12B?
Sir, Saksham.
Saksham.
Shriya Seth.
Yes. Shriya. And then from 12D. Priyanshi and Stefan. And then from 12E. Amneet is from D. No, from E. From 12F. Dilbak. And Sukman. Then we have from 12F, Param. 12A, Romika, Jasleen, and Harshit. Yes, it's good. And let's move back to the quiz. Clear? So this is a quiz on smartphone. Only Priyanshi has registered. The web link is this www.kahoo.it, the tool of Microsoft. And this is the game pin 740668. Amneet, done. Shriya, done. Harmandeep. Three students. Let's be quick. Yes, Vanshika done. Who is this magic? Yes, so now we have 8 students. 9, Sukman is done. 13 students are there. So I will wait for just 1 minute and then I will start the quiz. So quiz is based on the smartphones. Few questions are related to smartphones. We all are using these smartphones, and you will find the questions a bit interesting questions related to smartphones. So now we have 10 participants. So now let us start. So anyone who still wants to join in, first log into this kahoot.it. This is Microsoft tool and for quizzes. And this is the pin 740668. So let's start now. So the right answer is in front of you, Motorola. The first company we started the cell phone. So let's move next. The first smartphone was made in which year? 92, 99, 201, 2001, 2007. So the correct answer is 1992, when the first smartphone was there. So we have 6 correct answers. Next, third question. Which company made the first smartphone? IBM, Microsoft, Apple, Motorola. The question is about smartphone, not about the cell phone. So the correct answer is IBM. So the correct shot is 2 correct shots on this time. A bit difficult question this time. Mr. Param is leading now. Just true or false? More people in the world on cell phones than the toothbrush. So 7 on the true side, 3 on the false side. So 2 is the correct answer. Panchika leading. This is quite easy question. Nine answers. Yeah, most of them are correct. China is the correct answer. Question number 6. Mobile app with maximum users in 2017. So we have 9 answers. So most of you are on the right track. Facebook is the mobile app with maximum users, most users, 2017. Panchika still leading. The most downloadable downloaded game all the time on iOS. Ten answers. Well done. So most of you are correct. 6% on the correct side. Candy Crush. So, stay competitive competition. Let's move to the question number 8. Who makes more purchases on mobile, men or women? Two persons are left. One left. And we have 7 on the correct side. Men makes more purchases than women on mobile. So 7 on the correct side. So Panchika number 1, Tomika at number 2, Param at number 3. So move to the next question. How many times does an average American check their phones during the day? Ten answers. One person left. So 5 on the correct side. Only one person is on the correct side. 80 times is the correct answer. And only one person is able to make this question answer correctly. So who is that person? Panchika still leading and Romika not far behind. Question number 10. How many times do American millennials check their phones each day? भाई ये बीच में डिस्टर्ब ना करो. let's move to the next. So on these questions, how many times do American millennials, that the persons who took birth in the year 2000, check their phones each day? So 150 is the correct answer. Two persons have given the correct answer. Not easy question. So Vanshika, Romika and Justine. So the second last question. Very strange sort of a question. So five still on the correct side. 40% of the persons of the smartphone users would rather lose their voice than their phone for a day. So this is a choice they have to make. 40% people will make this choice. Last question. Now Romika leading. And number two, Vanshika, number three, Muskan. Let's move to the final question. Dash is the fear of being away from your smartphone. Nomophobia, pogonophobia, cyberphobia, and neophobia. So still we have so many correct answers. Not even a single correct answer. Zero is the correct answer. Yeah, so I think cyberphobia, most of the people might have won this one. Next, so this is now the podium time. Muskan at third place. Seven correct answer, Vanshika. And again, the seven correct answers by Romika. Maybe a bit faster. Jasleen followed by Jasleen and Param. So this was a quiz for the day on smartphones. Just to refresh yourselves a bit about the smartphones. So last time we have discussed about the conditions, and one thing I want to share about this quiz is I think most of you have given the more correct answers than me. I have just given one or two correct answers for this quiz, and I found that most of the students have given the correct answers. So good job. So let's move to the topic. Last time we have focused on the constraints. So who will briefly tell about the last topic, this constraints? Anyone briefly just telling about the constraints? Today we have a huge class and most of you have kept your cameras in the off site. Please, I request to everyone is clear. So now I am going to use the random numbers, and you will find few people leaving the class. Yes, anyone who is interested to voluntarily wants to revise on the constraints. Yes, Shriya. Yes, now.
So constraints are some conditions that are applied so as to get a particular type of value. we have so many kinds of constraints. For example, not null constraint, that is used to check that any value in our table is not a null value. Primary key constraint, to check that all the values are uniquely means unique in a row. Then unique constraint, to check whether all the values are unique or not. So these are some kind of constraints.
Clear. So constraints are basically the conditions that we want to apply on our tables. Clear. So this list of constraints: not null, unique, primary key constraint, formal key constraint, check constraint, default, and index. So already we have gone through all the constraints. Let's move next. Next we have the commands related to database. Clear. And here you see that how you can apply the constraints. So while you are creating the table, you can apply the constraints. Like here in this example, you see here, first of all, this on ID, not null, and primary. Basically, no need to go for not null constraint, just primary key will ensure this not null constraint. So first is the primary key constraint is applied on the ID of the person to make it a primary key. And then you have one more constraint is there, default constraint. So if at the time of inserting the record, we do not enter the city of the person, so automatically it will be entered as Jaipur. And then you have finally one more constraint is there, check constraint. So that is the age of the person should be greater than or equal to 18 for maybe for booking the room or like any sort of conditions that we applied on this table. Then you have an order table. Again, on the order table, you have this not null constraint on order ID and order number. And then again, they have applied the this primary key constraint on order ID and the person ID is kept as the foreign, which refers to the person's table ID. So with the help of these two tables, you can join these two tables. Clear? Agar in two tables ko join karna hai, toh koi bata sakta hai kaise join karenge? How we will join these two tables? Sort of a natural join it will be. And what is the purpose of joining these two tables? I want to join these two tables. First is this condition, and second is, what is the purpose of joining these two tables? Yes, anyone? We have two tables, persons table and order tables. I want to check that which person is making the orders for which product. Clear? And how I will be joining these two tables? What conditions will be there? Is there anyone who is ready to answer? I have asked, first question is, focus on the first question is, how to join these two tables? What will be the condition to join these two tables, persons table and orders table? Already humne student table aur faculty table ko join kiya hua hai, and we have to make a command for this one also. Any idea? Maybe it may be wrong also, but at least discuss. Yes, so Shriya will be making it right. Yes, Shri.
So we can join it by by connecting person's table ID with orders table order ID. That can be select star from a person where persons dot ID is equal to orders dot order ID.
Mm-hmm.
Or we can use inner join that.
Inner join is the natural join, na? लेकिन आप मेरे को पहले बताओ कि आप persons table में से आप कौन सा attribute pick करोगे?
Sir, ID.
ID of the person. Okay, fine. And which attribute from the orders table?
So order ID.
Order ID, ठीक है? चलो, let's say आपने ये दो attribute pick कर लिए. तो पर्सन आईडी कभी भी ऑर्डर आईडी के साथ मैच ही नहीं करेगी, इट विल नेवर मैच. एक पर्सन की आईडी ऑर्डर आईडी के साथ मैच कर सकती है?
सॉरी पर्सन आईडी फ्रॉम द सेकंड टेबल.
यस यस. सो सेकंड टेबल में से, सेकंड टेबल में से ये वाला एट्रीब्यूट पिक करना, क्योंकि इसी को तो हमने बनाया है फॉरन. ठीक है. सो आई वॉज ऑल्सो लुकिंग फॉर दिस अल्टरेशन. सो पर्सन आईडी के साथ इसको अगर हम और किसी के साथ हम इसको इक्वेट कर ही नहीं सकते. ठीक है जी. सो इन दोनों को आपस में इक्वेट करेंगे एंड देन वी विल बी एबल टू बेसिकली दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ जॉइन इज कॉल्ड द नेचुरल जॉइन और दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द इनर जॉइन. सो माई हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट टू एवरीवन इज हैविंग दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ स्लाइड्स विद यू. क्लियर. सो व्हाट इज द टास्क एट यू. हमारे पास जो जितना भी हमने एसक्यूएल के अंदर काम किया है उसके अंदर मोस्ट चैलेंजिंग टास्क जो अभी तक है हमारे पास, दैट इज द जॉइनिंग प्रोसेस. दो टेबल्स को नेचुरली कैसे ज्वाइन करना है या इनर ज्वाइन कैसे उसके ऊपर अप्लाई करना. सो दिस इज द टास्क. पहले ये वाला टेबल क्रिएट करो, पर्सन टेबल, उसके अंदर मेक फ्यू एंट्रीज, देन मेक फ्यू एंट्रीज इन टू द ऑर्डर टेबल एंड देन अप्लाई द कमांड फॉर ज्वाइनिंग दीज टू टेबल्स. सो ठीक है. यस हर्षिता आवाज आ रही है? यस हर्षिता, इसको प्रैक्टिकली इंप्लीमेंट कर सकते हो इसको? कौन कौन आप, कौन कौन इसको प्रैक्टिकली इंप्लीमेंट कर सकता है? वी हैव सो मेनी पर्संस. श्रिया विल बी एबल टू डू, वंशिका विल बी एबल टू. यस रेस्ट. यस दिलबाग हो जाएगा ये? इफ यू हैव टू ज्वाइन दीज टू टेबल्स विल यू बी एबल टू डू दिस और नॉट? मुस्कान. बोथ मुस्कान. रोमिका. सो लेट्स मूव नेक्स्ट. नेक्स्ट इज दी वन मोर वेरी वाइटल कमांड दैट इज ऑफ माई एसक्यूएल इज अल्टरिंग टेबल्स. सो अल्टर टेबल इज अ वेरी वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग स्टेटमेंट. आई हैव डिस्कस्ड इट अर्लियर ऑल्सो. वी कैन परफॉर्म सो मेनी फंक्शंस. क्लियर. लाइक फर्स्ट इज इफ यू हैव टू एड ए कॉलम. सो वट इज द सिंटैक्स इज अल्टर टेबल नेम ऑफ द टेबल देन इज द कीवर्ड एड एंड देन द कॉलम यू वॉन्ट टू एड एंड द डाटा टाइप ऑफ दैट वेरी कॉलम. So it doesn't mean that at the time of if you have skipped the adding a column at the time of creating the table, you still can add a column later on also with the help of alter table statement. So now we can deal with the structure after the create table only with the help of alter table statement, because two times we cannot apply the create statement on a single table. So first time if you have created a table, later on you can do it with the help of alter table statement. Similarly, you can drop a particular column also. The syntax is alter table. This is the keyword. Then is the name of the table. Drop is the keyword. Column name. Clear? This column says this is the keyword column, and then is the column name, that the column that you want to remove or delete. Clear? And the column will be deleted from the structure. And values both will get deleted. The next one is one more statement is there in that slide. Clear? Alter table table name modify. Yes, ये modify का क्या purpose है? कोई बता सकता है? What is the purpose of here in this slide? The purpose of modify statement. Yes, Muskan.
So to change the name or the data type of the particular column.
Yes. So we can change the data type, or if you want to change the name also, it is possible with the help of modify. If you want to just change the name, so we'll keep the data type same. Okay. And if you want to change the data type, that you can also do this. Yes. few more operations on the this one. Yes, here you can see that a constraint has been added here. Clear? Statement वही है, उसके last पे क्या किया हुआ है, not null constraint apply कर दिया. So you can apply the constraint also with the help of not null. If you have not applied the constraint during creating the table, you can do it later also. ठीक है. सेकेंड के ये वाली जो स्टेटमेंट है इसमें यूनिक कंस्टेंट लगाया हुआ है. थर्ड में अल्टर टेबल टेबल नेम एड कंस्टेंट अगेन ए यूनिक, दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द कंस्टेंट माय यूनिक कंस्टेंट एंड चेक कंस्टेंट लगाया हुआ है यहाँ. ठीक है जी, ऐसे हम प्राइमरी की कंस्टेंट भी लगा सकते हैं एंड वी कैन ऑल्सो ड्रॉप द कंस्टेंट ऑल्सो. अगर हमने टेबल के ऊपर कोई कंस्टेंट लगाया है एंड वी वॉन्ट टू डिलीट ए पर्टिकुलर कंस्टेंट ऑल्सो, सो यू कैन डू दिस ऑल्सो. Alter table table name drop constraint, this constraint is a keyword and this is the name of the constraint, so you can delete any of the constraint at any time with the help of this alter statement. Next is alter table table name and then is drop index, so we deal very less with the index. Still you can, if you have applied the created the index, you can delete the index also, constraint on the index, whatever the constraint you have applied on the index. Clear? Similarly, the primary key constraint is dropped here. Clear? And this is one more example. ठीक है, इन दोनों में क्या difference है, इन दोनों में क्या है, first में क्या है, ये statement के अंदर क्या किया हुआ है, इसमें constraint का नाम mention किया हुआ है और इसमें क्या किया हुआ है, इसमें अल्टर टेबल टेबल नेम ड्रॉप प्राइमरी की, और डेफिनेटली इस टेबल के ऊपर जो भी प्राइमरी की होगी वो प्राइमरी की क्या हो जाएगी, ड्रॉप हो जाएगी. सो समटाइम्स इन एग्जांपल्स में दो तरह का मैकेनिज्म यूज किया हुआ है. यू नो एक मैकेनिज्म में होता है कि अगर हम टेबल के अंदर कंस्टेंट का नाम डिफाइन नहीं करते तो डाटाबेस खुद ही कंस्टेंट का नाम बना देता है. ठीक है, जैसे when you are making a constraint but you don't name a constraint. मैं आपको example बताता हूं. ठीक है, जैसे यहां पे हमने add constraint किया है, alter table this statement, I will just highlight this one. ठीक है जी, तो इसमें मैंने क्या किया है, alter table name of the table add constraint this is a keyword, और ये है मेरे पास, this is the name of the constraint. नेम ऑफ द कंस्टेंट कंपल्सरी नहीं होता हमारे पास, सो यू कैन अप्लाई द कंस्टेंट विदाउट नेमिंग द कंस्टेंट आल्सो. सो देन व्हाट विल हैपन, अगर हम कंस्टेंट का नेम खुद मेंशन नहीं करेंगे तो माई एसक्यूएल ऑटोमेटिकली कंस्टेंट को एक नाम दे देगा अपनी साइड से. क्लियर, एंड देन वी विल बी हैविंग अ डिफिकल्टी इन सर्चिंग दैट वेरी कंस्टेंट. सो दीज आर द फ्यू इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट अबाउट द कंस्टेंट. क्लियर, now the next is the important topic is order by class. So who will help me out in this one? Yes, Harshita, padhna isko.
MySQL order by clause is used to sort the data table in either ascending order or descending order. By default, data is not inserted into tables in any order unless we have an index. So, if we want to retrieve the data in any particular order, we have to sort it by using MySQL order by statement.
Yes. So you can see here the syntax of this order by class. We have already gone so many times on the order by class. So select, you have to mention the names, then from table name order by. So by default, the values are basically ordered in ascending order, ASC. And if you want to keep it as descending, so you can use the keyword desk. Like here in this example, what has been done? You can see here the data, clear, roll number, name, class and marks. So what has been done here, select star from student order by class. So you can see here the classes are appearing in the which order, ascending order. First is class 1, then class 2, and then class 10, because all the classes are of same. Class 10 are basically three students from class 10 are clear. So yes, in the next slide you can see here what has been implemented here. Suppose we want having the student with table with the following data. This is the again data that we have. Select star from table and we want the class in the descending order. So now you see here class is 10 is appearing first, then class 2 and then class 1. So this is the example of descending order where you have to use this desk keyword. And one more example of this order by classes. कि जैसे यहाँ पे क्या है हमारे पास क्लास 10 का टाई है हमारे पास ठीक है तो मैं क्या चाहता हूँ आई वॉन्ट टू डू हेयर सिलेक्ट स्टार फ्रॉम स्टूडेंट ऑर्डर बाय क्लास इन दी असेंडिंग ऑर्डर क्लास शुड बी इन दी असेंडिंग ऑर्डर बट मार्क्स ऑफ ऑल दी स्टूडेंट मस्ट आल्सो अपीयर इन दी असेंडिंग ऑर्डर मीन्स पहले सबसे कम मार्क्स जिसके हैं जैसे विमल है उसके कम मार्क्स है उसके बाद विशाल है उसके बाद फ्रेय है सो दी मार्क्स जहां पे टाई हो जाएगा हमारे पास वहां पे फिर जो नेक्स्ट आपने ऑर्डर बाय क्लास के अंदर जो पैरामीटर यूज किया उसके ऊपर ऑपरेशन शुरू हो जाएगा बिकॉज देयर इज अ टाई इन क्लास सो देन दी स्टूडेंट्स आर डिस्प्लेड अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर मार्क्स इन दी असेंडिंग ऑर्डर वी हैव अप्लाइड दिस आल्सो अर्लियर आल्सो ठीक है जी सो अगेन हेयर इन दिस केस यू सी हेयर व्हेन द क्लास इज सेम सो मार्क्स आर अपीयरिंग इन द डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर फर्स्ट Freya with highest marks, Vishal and then Vimal with least among 10th. Yes. Now next is the, we have aggregate function and yes, Jasmine padhna aap.
An aggregate function performs a calculation on multiple values and returns a single value. For example, you can use the average function, aggregate function that takes multiple numbers and returns the average value of the numbers. Following is the list of aggregate functions supported by MySQL.
So, in our syllabus, we have the aggregate functions as sum, minimum, maximum. Average and count, which works on multiple values and returns a single value. That is the definition of a aggregate function. So we are all familiar with these functions, minimum, maximum. So I think we need not to discuss too much about this one. The next important thing is that we have a group by class. So just this last topic of the day, and who has not spoken? Till now, yes, Saksham. Saksham Raj. Yes. Just adding the number only. Yes, Dilbag Singh. दिलबाग पढ़ना
है सर नेटवर्क
पढ़ोगे इसको
सर नेटवर्क इश्यू सर सब दिखाई नहीं दे रहा डिस्प्ले नहीं हो रही
ठीक है सो आई विल रीड दिस आउट ग्रुप बाय क्लास groups a set of rows or records into a set of summary rows or records by the values of columns or expression. It returns one row for each group. So basically single value for each row it will return. We often use the group by class with aggregate functions such as sum, average, maximum, minimum and count. And the aggregate functions that appears in the select clause provides the information about each group. So here you can see the syntax for this one is select. These are the columns that we select. Then we apply the aggregate function on a particular column. and then from table, the table on which we are applying the query, and then we state the conditions, clear, by which the group will be made, clear. And its example we will start tomorrow, clear. What is the group by clauses and what are its relevant examples are there. We have already applied it in the last year also, and we will just revise this. Any question or any issue? Thank you, brother. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.